afterwards. And now we are joined over the phone by His Excellency Ambassador Mohammed Hegazi, former Assistant Foreign Minister. Good afternoon, Mr. Ambassador.
How are you, Shireen?
I'm fine. First, I would like to shed light on the upcoming visit of President Fattah el-Sisi to Ethiopia. It is expected in the coming day, in the coming days, and would like to know more about the importance and significance of this visit.
The 28th EU summit is in its regular meeting in Addis Ababa. From the 22, we kicked off already till the 31st. The summit will take place on the 30th and the 31st. The slogan of this very important summit is harnessing the demographic dividend through investment in youth.
Yes.
And this is a very important topic, particularly to Egypt, who will host in Aswan, if you may recall, next Friday and Saturday, the third youth meeting. We hosted one in Cairo and one in Sharm el-Sheikh, and this one will concentrate on the youth in Upper Egypt. So this is a very important venue for Egypt to present its experience and its initiatives towards youth. One more issue which will, I think, take the interest of this summit is the competition between five candidates contesting for the position of the African Union Commission chairperson. The summit will elect one of the five candidates who represent Senegal, Kenya, Equatorial Guinea, Chad, and Botswana. As you may recall, also in Rwanda and Kigali in the 27th summit, the leaders were not able, after many rounds of vote, to choose the new commission chairperson who will replace Mrs. Dlamini Zuma. So we are expecting a very important election, as well as the election of the deputy commissioner and eight other commissioners in different specialization of the African Union. Most importantly, also, is that Morocco will rejoin the Union. And
yes.
This is, I think, one of the highlights, because this is a return of one important Arab African countries which has contributed to the benefit and success of Africa and the African Union before its withdrawal, and now it's back to re-enhance, I think, Africa-Arab relations. Morocco is a very important partner to Africa, and we will be definitely stronger in Africa with Morocco next to us. I think, Shireen, what is important about this conference is its slogan, youth are the future, and we are living in a young nation and a young continent.
Yes.
So we will definitely look into this matter with importance, and I think Egypt has an experience to present. One more subject that is always there is the current situation of peace and security, the conflicts you have mentioned in your intro, the situation in Gambia,
yes,
and the situation in Burundi, Somalia, all that was in your report. So those issues will be among, although in Gambia the end was positive, and we're still struggling in Somalia, as well as the improved situation in Burundi, but other challenges remain to be discussed, including the challenge of terrorism, illegal immigration, and many other peace and security-related issues.
So do you expect President Fattah el-Sisi to tackle the issue of the Renaissance Dam on the sidelines of the summit?
Absolutely. The,
yes,
the meetings allows the president to talk on bilateral issues.
Yes.
But before that, we will indulge into the issues related to peace and security, because, as you may know, Shireen, Egypt,
yes,
has a double membership, one in the African Peace and Security Council for 3 years, and one as a non-permanent member in the security seat on the security, international security, UN Security Council.
Yes.
So Egypt is a bridge to express Africa challenges and to attract world attention to the crises and disputes and conflicts in Africa, as well as the challenges facing its political and economic quest for the future. So this is one of the area of interest of President Sisi, in which also he will discuss bilateral ties. You have all the African leaders and head of government gathered in one place, so it's an opportunity to further discuss bilateral ties.
Mr. Ambassador Mohammed Hegazi, former assistant for the Foreign Minister for African Affairs, thank you for being with us today. Now, dear viewers, this brings us to the end of today's edition of Africa Today. Sheena Adel, thank you for watching.